a lot of times, and you'll hear guys all the time, they'll say it early season when you've got little seedlings, they'll have purple plants, they'll say, I have an iron deficiency. It's like, no, that's most of the time, that's a genetic fault.
The little purple thing.
Yes. Now, if you get late into season and you're like around pollination, if you're pre what we call burn down where or firing up where the plant's beginning to turn the corner, it's produced in here. If you still have purple, lower, older leaves, you probably have an iron deficiency. There's also a thing called there are streaks that can form in the leaves, and then there's also interveinal beading. Yes. B-E-A-D-I-N-G.
Oh, not beating.
Yeah,
not
like, bleeding. I've heard people say interveinal bleeding. It's like, no,
chloroplasts don't bleed. That sounds bad. Go to the doctor. Yeah. You got it.
They have chloroplasts. They don't bleed. But instead of hemoglobin, right?
Yep.
There you go.
There you go.
Look at this kid right here.
Look at you go.
Yep. And, fun fact, chloroplasts. Plants are one of the only thing that actually chloroplasts have their own nuclei, which I did not know until botany.
Okay.
Thank you very much. Plant genetics and botany.
There you go.
That most of us have, you know, most organisms have one main nuclei and chloroplasts get their own. So because they have to produce their own sugars.
Okay.
How neat is that?
That is neat.
Okay. I just bored somebody. Mark's like, this is super.
Look, we're talking about chelation, not nuclei.
Like the other day we were talking about fermentation. Like, what is fermentation? Right now, I was like, glucose. He was like, I was looking for sugar, but that works. Nailed it.
Nailed it. Yeah. Got it.
Yeah. Yeah. It's like, oh, man. Polysaccharides? It's like, stop. But anyway, interveinal beading can actually happen, which looks. I'm sorry.
That's so funny. Such a funny term.
It is. It's because it happens between the veins.
Okay.
And it actually looks like early onset of gray leaf spot.
Say it one more time. Just say it one more time.
Interveinal beating. Somebody call a doctor.
I can't help it. It sounds so tacky.
It does. It's a real thing. It happens when there's an iron deficiency. I promise you.
I don't even want to try to say it.
You're going to have to say it with your
pinky out. I'm going to say it wrong. I'm just going to say it. Oh, my gosh. That's awesome. I'm not even going to try it.
Yeah.
Okay, so glyphosate ties up all of these nutrients. They may be in the soil, but it ties it up where the plant can't get to it.
Yep, exactly.
I'm good. All right. Any other major detrimental, you know, I mean, I think, you know, we talk about dicamba and the drift that it can go. Any other major, you know, kind of cautions or problems we're seeing with any herbicides?
I mean, that's kind of what I was saying. There have been quite a few studies through the university system about, you know, what we're doing and is it effective and are we being detrimental to the environment, and you're still thinking about interveinal beading, I can tell, but it's okay. So
I just can't stop. It's awful. It's like,
I knew it. I honestly thought to myself this morning, I was like, I kind of want to talk about that. That's really cool. Like, you know,
and you're like, nah, Mark's not mature enough to handle this.
Yeah. And they're like, no.
It just sounds awful. It's like, doctor, I think I've got interveinal bleeding. Okay, I'm sorry. I just can't help it.
I don't understand how we, like, you are a fairly sophisticated person.
I know. You get in
very deep conversations with people who have PhDs and master's degrees and people who have
good,
conversations. Like, we tried a podcast a while back. We were talking about male and female plants pollinating, which we talk about all the time in this office.
I know.
And you literally lost it.
Like,
we had to stop a podcast because you couldn't talk.
I know. I know. It's you guys. I mean,
the man has five children. He talks about lot of male and female corn play poly. And I was like, oh, Lord. What's going on?
I don't know. I get in the office with all of you guys, and it's like the sixth grade locker room around here. Yeah. You know, it's like you can't say
the
anything.
The dumbest jokes I probably, like, I think about a funny joke, I don't get anything out of Mark. Like, one time, I remember, here's a fun off-the-cuff story. Scott had some kind type of, like, he had gotten everybody in sales these, like, really dumb hands-free headsets.
For their phones.
Yeah, for their phones. Yes. And I remember, we were all standing around, I walked into an office, and I said, you gonna land that plane or what? And you literally lost it. Like, it looked like he worked at an air traffic control center. I was like, you bring that bird down or what?
Oh, we got hairs out. Yeah. Four Niner Jaybird.
Good stuff.
I know.
That's good.
I know.
All right.
We were all serious, man. We were going with it. And
sorry, marketing. I'm so sorry.
Oh my gosh.
I think we're just gonna let it ride.
Oh my goodness. Yeah. So, well, good. Kyle, as always, it is a pleasure, my friend. And I enjoy having you in and enjoy our friendship for sure.
Absolutely.
So one last thing. You snuck out last night to go to the Flatland Calvary concert in St. Louis. How was that?
It was awesome. Probably one of the best shows I've ever been to. Anybody who kind of has been around us or...
Nobody there with Tori. Interfatal beating.
No, right? Nobody did. But no, it was cool. We're... Yeah, no,
I can't
but
do it.
Some of those people might have it this morning, though. Yeah, I'll tell you that right now. But no, it was cool. We a lot of us, you know, especially us R&D guys, we're into the Texas Red Dirt scene, which is this small little genre of Texas music that basically only comes out of Texas, Oklahoma, Arkansas. And so for them to come up to St. Louis is awesome. I mean, it was not a lot of people there, but I mean, yeah, we got to meet the band. It's, I mean, they're just real laid back guys who are just making really good country music, so. It was neat.
Good deal. I'm glad you got to go. I'm glad I got to see the pictures and hear the story.
Hopefully.
I know.
Next week is Core Blood.
I know. We're crossing our fingers.
If you work in agriculture and you're not listening to Core Blood, you're missing
you're
out.
You're missing out. Absolutely.
If you love cows, you need or breaking stuff or getting your truck stuck. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Absolutely. Absolutely. So good. Hey, appreciate you, buddy.
Absolutely.
Hey, guys, all you out there listening, appreciate you tuning in today, so to speak, and hope you enjoyed this as much as we did. As always, you can find us on Facebook, YouTubes, and at always at seedcorn.com. Catch y'all later. We'll be right back.